Sunday service. My name is Brother Collins, and at this time I would love to welcome our present worship team of All Souls Cathedral. Welcome. Song. We will start with a word of prayer. Let's believe and pray. Our dear Heavenly Father, God Almighty, King of Kings, we bless you, we honor you, and we give you thanks for this day. Thank you, Lord, for gathering us together, my Lord, King of Glory, at such a time like this, just to hear your word, O God, Father, King of Glory, and also, my Lord, King of Glory, to teach us, to instruct us, to rebuke us, and to correct us, O Lord. We bless your God, Father, King of Glory, and we honor you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. So our sermon of today is from the book of Psalms 125. And now we read. The Bible says that those who trust in the Lord are like Mount Zion, which cannot be shaken but endures forever. As the mountains around Jerusalem, so the Lord surrounds his people, both now and forevermore. The scepter of the wicked will not remain over the land allotted to the righteous, for then the righteous might use their hands to do evil. Lord, do good to those who are good, and to those who are upright in heart, but those who turn to crooked ways, the Lord will banish with the evil doers. Peace be on Israel. So this is the book of Psalms 125, and this is one of the ascents, the song of ascents, that were being sung by the children of Israel after the Lord has enable them to come a long way from the slavery, from captivity, from all the suffering to where they are now. And as you can see from the book of Psalms, chapter 120 to 134, we saw earlier that actually there are 15 Psalms of the saints, and that you can divide them up to five groups or three. Each group of three Psalms follows a similar patterns of trouble, trust, and triumphs. There were times for trouble, there were times for triumph, for trust, where they trust on God. And now Psalms chapter 125 is where we are now seeing the triumph, the victory. And as you can also see that in the Psalms 124, the trust Psalms in this group, which was about depending on God. Now we can come to Psalms 125, you know, the triumph Psalms in this group. In the book of Psalms, chapter 125 is now where they have now overcome. Now it is a triumph, a victory for them. And this beautiful psalm is one of the series of songs that people of Israel, will sing joyfully together as they stream upward to the city of Jerusalem to celebrate the feast of Jehovah or of Christ, of Jesus Christ. They journey together in prayer, in praise, as they started to ascend in the hill of Zion. They were on their way to celebrate the annual festival of the Lord, and as they journey together, they joyfully recite the songs of ascent, which are found in the book of Psalms 120 to Psalms 134. So all these were actually the people of Israel trusting upon the Lord. And in the book of Psalms chapter 125, the Bible says, I will read verse 1 and 2. The Bible says, those who trust in the Lord are like Mount Zion, which cannot be shaken, but endures forever. So remember the children of Israel, after passing through hardship, you know, through the hands of Pharaoh, they passed through, and also having 40 years, spending 40 years in the wilderness, they had a hardship. They saw a lot of things happening to them. And now the Lord finally delivered them, and they began to sing the psalms, you know, from the Psalms of Psalms 120 to Psalms 134. And we see Psalms 125 is coming in as one of the songs that they sang on their way to Jerusalem. What a beautiful city, as they sang on that beautiful city. And in this mountain, and as they say, that those who trust in the Lord are like Mount Zion, which cannot be shaken, but endures forever. The reason why they sing this song like this, because they know they place their trust in the Lord from the first day when God spoke to Moses to deliver them from Egypt to now where now they are. And that's why they say that indeed those who trust in the Lord, they are like Mount Zion, which cannot be shaken, but endures forever. That how beautiful that if me and you, we put our trust in the Lord, we are like Mount Zion. And from that verse, we draw our lesson that indeed those who trust in the Lord are safe and secure. And therefore, you are like Mount Zion, which cannot be shaken, but endures forever. If you are a believer, you are born again Christian, and you trust upon the Lord, you are like Mount Zion. You can't be shaken. You can't be moved, because you are stronger. You know, we used to sing a song that, you know, on Christ the solid rock I stand. You know, it's only the sweetest frame that we can lean on, that all other ground are sinking sand. And those are the songs we used to sing, because Christ is the only foundation. Christ is the only hope of glory. Christ is the only one that we can lean upon. He's the only one we can trust upon. Our hope is in Him. And therefore, you is there who is trusting upon the Lord. Know that you are strong. You are like Mount Zion. And part B, that the Lord surrounds you on every side. You know, as the Bible says in verse 2 of Psalms chapter 1, that as the mountains surround Jerusalem, so the Lord surrounds His people both now and forevermore. What a beautiful thing to know that you as a believer, that indeed that Christ God surrounds you. You have a protection. You have a secure place whereby you are being protected. That wherever you go, whether you are at your job place, wherever places you are, you know, you are surrounded by the Lord. How beautiful, how amazing, how glorious that indeed you and me are surrounded by the Lord. That whether I sleep, whether I wake up, we are surrounded by the Lord. So take this home, that you who is there, don't feel insecure. Know that you are surrounded like Mount Zion. And then part two, that those who trust in the Lord are secure inheritance. And that's why we see in the book in verse 3, the scepter of the wicked will not remain over the land allotted to the righteous, for then the righteous might use their hands to do evil. Lord, do good to those who are good and to those who are upright in heart. But those who turn to the crooked ways in the Lord will banish the evildoers. We see the Bible says that indeed the wicked, you know, there is a land that remain that is allotted for them. But for us who are righteous, there is a promised land. And that's why Jesus came and he said that indeed he is life. And he came to give us, he gave us life and life in abundance. And that life is that of which we walk in upon. And that life is which we are waiting to see one day when our Christ Jesus come back. And that is, this is the greatest promise that they were singing. And they say that indeed there is a great inheritance, that if you trust upon the Lord, if you trust, if you put your hope in God, you will never fail. You will never have trouble. You will never have, you know, you don't need to be insecure. You don't need to be unsure, because Christ is on your side. That's what the Bible says, if Christ is for us, therefore who can be against us? Because Christ is for us. He overcame that we may overcome. And therefore, dear children of God, dear child of God, know this, that you already overcome. And also how we see that those who trust in the Lord have a secure future. That indeed it's not only in this life, in the world to come, maybe in the glorious world to come, we say heaven, but also our future is secure. And that we see in the book of Jeremiah, when Jeremiah says that, you know, that those indeed, that if you trust upon the Lord, you know, in the book of Jeremiah, where he says that the Lord has our future. He knows that of which the future belongs. He knows the future that he has for us, and he has a good plan for me and you. So because the Lord have a good plan for me and you, because the Lord has a brighter future for us in this, the land of the living. So if you put your trust upon the Lord, tomorrow is great. Tomorrow is bright. I know we live in uncertain times when COVID-19 struck the world, all over the world, and people were asking questions, you know, where, how will it be? We have seen people lost their lives. We have seen several things happening. We have seen pain. We have seen people losing their jobs. We have seen a lot of things happening. But is there hope? Some people say, is there hope? You know, people were sleeping hungry. People were doing other things just for them to survive. Now the country is trying to back to the normals. You know, you're trying to make things, to make the ends meet. But there is still hope. There is still trust. You know, and just as the children of Israel sang, and they said that those who trust in the Lord are like Mount Zion. And you are like Mount Zion. Your future is secure. Your future is secure. Because the Lord is the one who holds your future, and therefore tomorrow belongs to him. We may not know that of which tomorrow is, but God is the one who knows us, is the one who began a good work in us. The Bible says that the one who begin a good work in you will bring into unto completion. The same Lord who began a good work in the children of Israelites, and now they sang a song of triumph. So is it to us, dear brethren, that indeed we may be passing through hardship. Indeed, we may be passing through hard situation. Don't turn back to worship idols. Just like we saw the children of Israel in some point when they were in desert, they were asking Moses, can you return us back to the place, to the desert, to Egypt? You know, because they wanted to go back. Don't ever want to go back to a toxic situation. Don't ever want to go back to a place where you are at your comfort zone. The hardship may be there. Maybe you're beginning your business and you are not seeing hope. Maybe you are trusting God for a child. Maybe you are trusting God for a future, for a spouse. You know, maybe you are trusting God for money, for job. This is a great promise that God is bringing to us today, that the future is in His hand, and therefore us who trust in Him, our future is secure. It may not seem like it's happening. Sometimes when we are in trouble, things may not seem like happening, but when we look back, one day when you look back is when you'll say, thank you God, you did it this way. Because if the children of Israel knew that indeed they will have this sweet life that they were having as they sing this song, you know, they will have not complained in the land of the wilderness. So, dear brethren, where is your trust? Is your trust in the Lord, or is your trust in the other thing? The Bible says that some trust in chariots, some trust in horses, but we put our trust into the Lord. Will you put your trust in horses? Will you put your trust in chariots? Will you put your trust in other things that doesn't matter? Where do you put your trust upon? Me, I choose to put my trust upon the Lord. And that's why I'm saying that put your trust in the Lord. The situation seems hard. The way may seem unclear. But tomorrow, you know, the Bible says that though the darkness endures for the night, but there is a light, there is a hope at night. In the morning, there is a hope that is coming for us. And at night when there's darkness, you may not see, you may not know that indeed there will come a light, but there is a light that's coming. So let's put our trust in the Lord, in the hard situation, in the hard moment, in the difficult situation, when things are not happening, when even sometimes you don't see like, is this God working or not God? When you have questioned God, where is you God? Why all this are happening to me? Know this one thing, the child of God, that there is a hope. There is a hope for tomorrow. And Christ have assured us this hope that indeed persecution may happen, trouble may come, but it's only endures for a little time. Put your trust in the Lord. One day you will sing a victorious song, just as in the book of Psalms 125, the children of Israel sang, and they say that indeed this was a tribute of God, long suffering, praise for His goodness and grace, thanksgiving for His everlasting mercy, and demonstrated a united reverence toward His holy name. This was indeed, they were thanking God 40 years in the wilderness, and they are now, you know, without water. Sometimes they lacked water, sometimes they faced through hardship. You know, do you know what happened in the wilderness, in the desert? It's a terrible thing. You know, if you are told today to go into a desert, trust me, you will not like it. But this the children of Israelites, they face it through, and they're now singing the jubilee song. And as a believer, God has proved Himself to be faithful to His people in the past, and they were confident of His continuing goodness and grace towards them. And so they were able to sing together in union. Those who trust in the Lord are as Mount Zion, which cannot be moved, but peace abide forever. And I know that in your faith, if your faith is in Christ, then you are safe and secure. You are like Mount Zion, which cannot be shaken, but endures forever. As the mountains around Jerusalem, so the Lord surround His people every side. What a beautiful thing. The Lord surrounds you and me. And therefore, dear brethren, wherever you're watching this, I know that maybe the situation you are in may seem to be unclear, but keep on trusting upon the Lord. Keep on trusting upon the Lord. Our trust is in Him alone. And because He's the one who holds our future is secure in His hands. So if your faith in Jesus Christ, know this, that indeed you will sing a song of joy, just like as the children of Israelites sang this song. And so as I end my sermon, maybe you are there watching this, and maybe you have put your trust in money, maybe your trust is in your parents, maybe your trust is in the human being, other things. The Lord is calling unto us. Know that when your trust is not in Christ, then your future is insecure. Know that you are not like Mount Zion, you can be shaken any time. So will you want to put your trust in God? Will you want to give your life to Jesus Christ? Jesus came that we may have life and have it in abundance. So if you are there watching at home, I would love you to pray this prayer with me. Lord Jesus, thank you for sharing your word with me this day. Lord, I confess my sin, that indeed I have put my trust in other things. I have placed my trust in money. I have placed my trust in the things of the world, but they have never benefited me, God. May you forgive me, Lord. Father, Lord Jesus, today I put my trust in you and only you, for you are the hope of glory. And, O Lord God, accept me and receive me as your son and as your child, and help me to walk through this journey. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Thank you, Heavenly Father, for sharing, for Lord God, King of Glory, speaking to us that indeed, Abba Father, King of Glory, just like you assured the children of Israelites that, oh Lord God, Father, you are taking them to a safer place, and now they are coming to sing a song of triumph for you in the Psalms of 125, oh Lord. Father, King of Glory, indeed you have come to prove that you have promises, and yes, and amen. Lord, King of Glory, Father, as we keep on trusting in you, as we keep on hoping in you, as we keep on, our Father, King of Glory, walking with you, Lord, may you hold our hands, may you lead us through every trouble, every struggle, every situation, God, for our hope is in you, and our confidence is in you, O Lord. For this is our humble prayer of faith, in Jesus' name. Amen. Thank you so much for watching our sermon today. And may God bless you and do you good. Please remember to send your offering, your tithes, and also your thanksgiving. You're welcome to All Souls Cathedral. Our services are on, and so please feel welcome every Sunday. God bless you and do you good.
Behold, you're standing at the door. You knock. I let you in, Lord. I surrender.